Howdy, folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Shadowrun Hong Kong. Yeah. I might have missed it last time. But the music and the whispers. Somebody trying to play some horror behind the security door. Let's knock, shall we? As you approach the door, a light set into your key fob goes from red to green. There's a loud series of thunks, and the door slides open. A blast of frigid air floods into the room from the other side. An expensive, consumer-grade computer terminal awaits your input. The display background is set to a screen capture from Promises in Moonlight. Penelope Wong's radiant face beams at you from the corner of the screen. Why, if it isn't Ma's personal terminal? A sly smile crawls up Isabel's cheeks. She cracks her knuckles. Let's have a look. Log into the computer as a guest. A few keystrokes is all it takes to get into the computer's file structure. With the high-tech security door in his apartment, it seems Ma never bothered to encrypt his machine. An options menu appears on the screen. Well, let's unlock the office door. With the push of a button, you unlock the office door on the other side of the room. An ominous thunk reverberates through the cold steel apartment. Financial records. Neville's financial records are astoundingly boring, aside from two major things. He spent next to nothing on his hospital bills, where it appears he only stayed for 3 days, and he's spending a lot of money on a woman named Ku Feng. Jewelry, bills, clothes, and such. And the email. You read through Ma's email, most of it's spam and boring business arrangements, but one detail stands out. Neville Ma is frequently emailing a woman named Ku Feng. They seem close, exchanging a lot of thinly veiled flirtation. It appears that Neville has been lavishing Ku Feng with money and affection. Expensive gifts, rent checks, miserable attempts at poetry. Seeing to it that her every need is met. Alright. Is she a vampire? Is Mist? Oh my god! There's no one at the piano. Without warning, a frigid wind blows through the apartment. The chill cuts through your clothing, raising goose flesh all over your body. Where's that coming from? There's another blast of cold, and a pale and imposing woman materializes out of thin air. A throng of black-faced men and women materialize alongside her.
Ah, the little dog who's been sniffing around Neville Ma's affairs.
Her voice is imperious, arrogant. Pointy teeth. Ku Feng, I presume? She nods.
Just so. My servants have been watching you since you arrived. I suspect that you're an evil man and that you're here to do harm to Neville, and so I came to stop you.
Let's read her aura. You focus your vision on the astral plane and expand your senses to take in the woman's aura. Black shadows color her essence, the kind of markings often found in the auras of terminal cancer victims and vampires. Well, I think I know your secret. She raises an eyebrow.
Oh? And what do you intend to do with this knowledge? Oh my god! The hopping vampires!
I don't know that we necessarily want to taunt her, because I would assume that in Shadowrun, vampires would be something you'd not want to get into it with. I don't know. I think I need to know more about you before I decide.
A wise decision. Acting without knowledge is the mark of a fool. Know then that I am Kufang and that my servants have been watching you since you arrived. You think yourself so clever, sniffing around Neville's affairs like an amateur detective. So sly, so quiet. But you're not quiet enough to escape my ears, little man.
I couldn't be less interested in hurting Neville. I'm just here to finish a job.
If that is true, then it is a shame. You have seen my face and you know what I am. Naturally, I cannot allow you to leave, and you cannot afford to fight me here for fear of police involvement.
She lifts her chin imperiously.
Perhaps we can settle this in a more civilized manner, a face-off in a neutral location. Will you accept my challenge?
A duel at midnight works for me.
Very well.
She steeples her fingers.
As for the terms, if I win, you willingly submit to my influence. You become my pawn. And if you win...
We'll cross that bridge when we come to it. She nods, grinning.
Wait 15 minutes for the sun to go down, and then come to the roof. We'll settle this there, like ladies and gentlemen.
The sun dips below the horizon. Mist coalesces, coating the rooftop in dew. Kufang and her cohorts appear.
Are you prepared to become my servant, human? You must not resist or I'll be forced to kill you. Should it come to that, I'll endeavor to make it swift and painless, but no promises.
I'll see what you got.
This will be entertaining. Kill him.
All right. Well, they got numbers on us, but it looks like they're mostly melee? Oh no, those guys have pistols, okay. So is she not among them? I do not see her. I see dudes with machetes. Oh no, there she is, okay. So what do we got? I think that's a machete, that's a machete, that's a machete. This guy, I can't tell, so I'm going to assume pistol, pistol, pistol. All right. Well, they're all nicely clumped up over here, so fireball. Damn it, Devon, of course you miss. Go ahead and cast aim on, where is my dwarf? There's her and the bot are in the same square. That's gonna be awkward. Oh, wait, what? Wait, what? Go back. I didn't realize that his accuracy was now an AoE buff. All right, murder drone. Oh, having these extra action points, like this was a game changer in Dragonfall. So I'm sure it's gonna be huge here as well. Okay. I think we're just gonna worry about what's currently in our grill and then go from there. Alright, yeah, that dude does have a pistol. Also, he's bleeding. And now he's dead. Murderbot, you complete me. Okay, Ractor, you, my friend, need to move to cover. Okay, Isabel. Ooh, I'm gonna have her move here. Just start tunking grenades out. Not too worried about accuracy, I just want her putting them out there. Nice, wow, 25 damage. To the pain. Let's go ahead and throw some rounds out on Gobbit, have her move tentatively. Come on. Game. I hate the movement in this game sometimes. All right, and we will have her go ahead and a devil rat. This is new. So let's see what the devil rat do. We'll go ahead and plunk it down right up here. Well, it's a rat. What does it do? It gnaws on things. It splashes venom and draws attention, apparently. It doesn't move very much, though, but that's only because it's our first round out here. I think I'm just going to have it pass. Okay, so it looks like the dudes with swords slash machetes are maybe adepts. At least that one is. You leave my dwarf alone. Ow. Okay, so the upside to us having the 3 AP now is that essentially Isabel can go through her full routine every turn. She can reload and tunk out 2 grenades, like, without fail. The problem is that they are no longer clumped together. And this dude is in her face. Sure. God damn! That pistol is so nasty! I don't know if it's just because she, like, scored a crit there, or what, but holy hell. Alright, I'm gonna move Devon up to here. And this guy is our current, like, threat, because he's in the grill of my party members. Ah, terrible. Murderbot, you do you. Okay, Ractor. Oh my god, this dude is impervious. Alright, let's introduce him to the Devil Rat and see if this maybe goes a little bit better. Oh, and it deals AP damage. Alright, he's no longer a threat, which pleases me. Gobbit. We'll have her haste Devon. I'm not even gonna try. I'm not even gonna try because he's gonna just miss and I'm gonna fuck it, I'm gonna try. Haha! Never a doubt in my mind. Dude's totally an adept. Like, he has an actual sword. That looks like a straight sword or something. Whereas the other dudes were, like, toting around machetes. Oh, I gotta move Devon up, but this is, like, such a bad place to do it. God, that's gonna take... Yeah, okay. Nice. Good old 20 damage. How is the murder? I think the murder bot's probably... Yeah, the murder bot's just fine. I don't think he can really do too much. Can he increase its accuracy from there? He can. Wonderful. He could also move speed increase or heal it, but I'm not really too interested in that. So he can just take a round and... Yeah, system works. All right, Isabel. Pull that grenade launcher back out. God, that was horrible. Let's target this guy. That way, if she goes left or right, it'll at least... Sure! I appreciate that the murder bot looks back at her and is like, seriously, bro? Seriously. Come on, now. Oh, damn it! Ugh. Accidentally waste the murder bot's AP because... clicking. It seems like they made these totems a lot more powerful in this one. Because, like, in Dragonfall, I remember, you know, going for 4 rounds, like, 4 AP on a spirit more than, like, the first round. Like, you were getting risky. I don't know. She's punching my robot. Lady? Lady, you're gonna regret... Did she just punch my robot to death? No. But she disabled it. What? I don't know what she did, but my robot can't robot no more. I am beside myself with grief. And that guy's beside himself and dead. We're gonna go ahead and reload and attempt to shoot her. I don't know what happened. All right. I mean, I guess we can just go ahead and start moving our people out because she's the only one that's still up. They're both stunned. Leave the robot alone, you fiend. That is like so tempting for a grenade. Man, Isabel is a monster with that pistol. Okay, here we go. Yeah, now we're getting there. We're gonna try it. So I assume if this thing escapes, I can just have her use her thing that lets her control spirits and we'll get it back again. This dude is stunned. And we missed four 66% chances to hit in a row. Y'all better believe I'm salty about that one. Uh-oh. Dog's going off. Uh-oh. That's probably UPS. I'm expecting a package today. Oh no. Oh wow. Oh, come on. Oh, I would have been really impressed if she hit that. I'm not upset that she didn't. I'm gonna murder my dog back in a minute. Okay, we are back. I apologize for that. Such is the other burden of recording during the day. Ain't no thing. Dog has been given pets for defending the household against the vile encroaching darkness of UPS. Oh, she can only have one minion. I was gonna summon that nature elemental and just box this chicken and beat the crap out of her. Alas, I guess we can just heal Reactor. Oh yes. Ooh. We'll go for 20. When it comes to these things, I am incredibly risk averse. Okay, so she does not take AP damage, and I'm gonna go ahead and banish this thing now. You leave my front line. Oh! A block! Oh, I bet she felt that one. I mean, get the hell. I don't know that it's necessarily a good idea to be near this woman because she is a vampire. Can we get our robot back? No! Oh, yep, there we go. I was gonna say. Holy crap. Robot, do your robot thing. Kufeng's calm and haughty demeanor dissolves as her eyes grow cold. Wait, I surrender. Don't kill me. What's wrong? Not feeling so powerful now? She claps her hands, pleading. The whole Mistress of the Night thing is just an act. Just an accountant that got infected. I don't really know how to fight. I was faking it. I just wanted to scare you into backing down. Look how that turned out.
Yeah, I know I blew it. I knew this duel was a bad idea the moment I agreed to it, but I couldn't back down in front of my pawns. It would have been humiliating.
She looks away.
Like I said, I'm just an accountant. I never went to vampire school. What I did do was get drunk on a business trip, black out, and wake up in an alley like this.
And so you, what, decided to embrace the whole vampire thing?
What choice did I have? I couldn't go back to work, and I was a dead-end job anyway. No upward mobility, no room for growth. I did what anyone would have done. I tried to make the best of it, to capitalize on my new abilities. I'm a vampire now, I can't control that, but I can control how I choose to monetize it.
So, what was your endgame? How'd you see this working out?
It beats me. It's not like I have a rulebook for this or anything, I'm just making it up as I go along. Who knows, maybe I could eventually become the Vampire Queen of Repulse Bay.
Well, I suppose I can't fault your ambition.
Thanks, I mean that, but it's never going to happen. I'm not any good at this, I know that now.
She looks away in shame, and her voice goes flat.
I don't even know what I'm going to do with myself now. If I'm ever found out, I'll get killed for the bounty money. This is my only real shot, and I blew it.
How'd you manage to survive?
I've just been hiding out in Kowloon. I was hoping to disappear. As far as my friends and family know, I'm missing, maybe dead.
Her chest hitches. She looks miserable.
I think that's for the best. I mean, how could I explain what I'd become? Can you imagine how ashamed my family would be to find that I'd become this monster? No, it's better that they think I'm dead. So, can we call a truce or something? I scratch your back, you let me live?
She clasps her hands, pleading.
What do you say?
This is not at all the case. We never agreed on what happened if she lost the duel. I think we can work something out, conditionally. She nods eagerly.
Yes, yes, anything. Just tell me what you need.
Well, first off, I want some answers.
I'll tell you whatever you want to know. You ask the questions, I'll answer. No lying, I promise.
So how are you and Neville Ma connected?
I happen to be in the same hospital he was, trolling for a meal. I don't like to drink blood from unwilling people, so I go to hospitals at night looking for people who won't mind if I take a sip. People in comas, patients with terminal illnesses, that kind of thing. Makes me feel better about what I have to do. So I wandered into his room and I recognized him. I'd seen him on the news, photos of the accident. He was in really bad shape, a lot of broken bones and internal injuries, but somehow he was still conscious.
So you offered to help.
Well, I knew if I gave uninfected people my blood that they'd heal just like I did, just not as fast. I'd figured that out early and by mistake, but it came in handy from time to time, so when I saw he was conscious, I decided to make my grand appearance. I materialized in the room and told him I'd make him a trade. I'd fix him up good as new, but he'd owe me some favors for it. I wasn't specific as to how many favors or what kind. He agreed. Actually, he leapt at the chance to become my pawn. I guess that when you're all broken up like that, you'll do just about anything to get better. The deal was done, and we got along. I think he's charming, he thinks I'm funny, and he doesn't care that I'm a vampire. He told me he gives me nice things because he likes me and not because he owes me his life. It's all very sweet.
Is there a cure?
I wish, but no. The only cure is being tossed in a bonfire or having your head cut off, and almost every nation in the world will pay a bounty for a dead vampire. It's not like I had much of a choice, you know? Be a vampire or get killed for some quick cash. It's a pretty raw deal either way.
We don't really care what it's like to be a vampire, so we've decided what's going to happen.
Okay, she exhales heavily. What's it going to be?
Can we get a vampire? I mean, can I do multiple things? Because this is the main thing, but a vampire could be a powerful ally. Ooh, do we prioritize the run or do we prioritize our own game? We prioritize the run, that's what Devon would do. You're going to get Neville to fire Penelope Wong.
Wait, well, this is about that stupid soap opera.
That's about the size of it, yeah.
I can't believe it, of all the idiotic reasons to blow my cover. Fine, I'll make Neville get rid of her.
Are you sure you can convince him?
He can't say no to me, I mean that quite literally. He'll do it, no question. And what about Neville and I?
I don't care who he associates with.
Thank you. He knows what I am and doesn't care because I saved his life. I won't trouble you again.
Alright. I guess that's it? I was... Alright. Sure. To the mezzanine. I guess we're done here then. We just leave. That was certainly interesting. The clink of glasses and sound of Neville Ma's party fades into the distance as you leave the Repulse Bay. As the MTR carries you towards Hiyue, the mountain of Hong Kong rolls slowly by as looming masses obscured by rain and storm clouds. Penelope Wong has been fired from Promises in Moonlight, and Ma will be at a serious disadvantage without her. The whims of Trid viewers shift as readily as the tide, and without the Starlet's presence, Promises in Moonlight will undoubtedly lose ratings. However, with Ku Feng at his side, Neville Ma may be able to thwart any of Dr. Shen Yang's attempts to undermine his other businesses. That's okay. We were only hired to do this one thing. And if they're, like, legit happy together, I'm more power to them. Oh, we only gained 4 karma. Damn it! I was hoping for the 8. Apparently, like, 8 might only be, like, the big story beat missions. I don't know. Because we want to level our quickness up. So we'll do that. And then next time we're probably going to work towards getting our rifle up. But I am going to go ahead and call it here. And next time, I guess... Well, we'll talk to the doctor. And then we're going to go and meet Dreamland. So, as per usual, folks, I hope you guys had a good time. And I will catch you all next time. We're in further adventure. Until then.